Being the Queen of England, or just being in her presence, comes with a lot of rules. You have to stand up when she does, you can't eat garlic, the royals aren't allowed to play Monopoly, and so on and on. But we all know that breaking the rules sometimes gives you that irreplaceable rebellious adrenaline, and it looks like Queen Elizabeth II knows that too well, because she is no stranger to breaking a few of the royal rules herself. After all, some rules are just meant to be broken, right? Who run the world? Girls. And boys. Being a member of the royal family is kind of like a way more polite British version of the Game of Thrones. As in, everyone hopes to have a chance at gaining that title. And we mean everyone. Because, as you know, being in line for succession is kind of a big deal. But they're all just kind of patiently waiting to maybe one day have a chance. The birth of Prince George was the one that made the Queen change one of the biggest royal rules of all. As you know, when it comes to ruling anything, there's a strong male bias involved. But the succession to the crown Act 2013 changed that forever. Instead of the male bias, the act now follows the rule that the order of succession is determined by the order of birth instead. By doing so, the Queen allowed future princesses to actually be in line of succession. This also changed another rule. Previously, the titles of prince and princesses only belonged to the monarch's children and grandchildren, which means Prince William's and Prince Harry's kids wouldn't technically qualify. But with this act, even the birth of Princess Charlotte affected the succession line. She actually bumped Prince Harry down one place. And the more kids Prince William has, the harder it'll be for Prince Harry to ever become the king. The Queen also made an exception to her reportedly favorite grandchild, Peter Phillips. He wasn't born with a royal title, but she did offer him a courtesy title, which his parents decided to turn down. However, this kind of proved that the Queen does play favorites every once in a while. Flowers for the lady? Most likely not, thank you. The Queen doesn't really accept flowers, because truth be told, she'd probably be left with hundreds of bouquets and would need to set up a flower room storage. Good idea, but not very practical. So the royal protocol rules state, no flowers for the lady. But in May 2019, the Queen held a garden party at Buckingham Palace, and a Belfast-based blogger, Lara Ann Barr, was invited, which is kind of a big deal. Lara Ann wanted to show her appreciation, so she wanted to give the Queen a gift, a bouquet of flowers. It probably wasn't a good idea, and everyone told her it's not the protocol, but sometimes you just have to try your luck. And for Lara Ann, it paid off, because the Queen actually accepted them. The two shared a very sweet moment, and the flowers were then passed on to the lady in waiting. But the accepting gesture shocked both the blogger, the public, and security. Lara Ann said the staff were completely stunned, and they even congratulated her for pulling that off. She said that, quote, "I suppose it's not really meant to be done at a garden party, but I was only going to have one chance of meeting the Queen, and I was going to give it my all." Saying I do to Roman Catholics. The Succession to the Crown Act 2013 didn't just remove the male bias, it also affected who the royal family can marry. Ever since 1701, members of the royal family weren't allowed to marry a member of Roman Catholic Church. If they did so, they would lose a place in the line of succession. With the 2013 Act, the Queen removed that rule forever. The change of that rule actually put a few of the royals, like Prince Michael of Kent, back in the line of succession. This also affects Lord Nicholas Windsor, whose entire family is Catholic. This also secures the future of the royal children, should they want to marry someone belonging to the Roman Catholic Church. Keeping up with the royal family. No, the royal family doesn't have their own reality show, but the Queen is the reason why their lives became much more public. Of course, technology plays a huge part in this, but it was ultimately the Queen's decision. The official royal rules of the past didn't really televise royal events, but in 1953, the Queen decided she wants her coronation to be shown on TV. It was a huge step in getting out of the comfort zone, especially since it has been reported that the Queen is actually very shy. But since the royals are all about bringing people together, this move made total sense. It was about the first time cameras were ever allowed into Westminster Abbey. Because she broke that rule in 1953, the public also got to witness a royal wedding for the first time in 1960. Her younger sister got married, and the wedding was the first televised royal wedding of the time. And and it was viewed by millions of people around the world. Nowadays, royal weddings are absolutely huge events with people coming into town just to watch the members of the royal family get married. And it's all thanks to the Queen for stepping out of her comfort zone and deciding to give us a glimpse into the lives of the royals. The D word. As in divorce. The royal family has a strange relationship with divorce. Before 2002, it was actually forbidden for a royal to marry someone who's divorced and still have a living ex-spouse. Now, this rule caused a lot of headaches for Prince Charles, whose divorce with Princess Diana was finalized in August of 1996. The first rule the Queen has broken was actually wanting to let Princess Diana keep the title of the Royal Highness after her divorce. Unfortunately, Prince Charles didn't allow that. But establishing the new rule that royals are not allowed to marry a divorcee helped Charles get married to Camilla Parker Bowles. Both Prince Charles and Camilla were previously divorced, and their whole relationship caused a lot of public scrutiny. So you can probably imagine that they both welcomed this 2002 royal rule change. But here's the thing, despite a broken rule, the Queen made it very clear she doesn't approve and didn't even attend the pair's wedding. However, she did attend and consent the wedding of Prince Harry and Meghan Markle. As you know, Meghan divorced her ex-spouse in 2013. Christmas traditions bias. Speaking of the lovely Meghan Markle, it does appear that the Queen is very fond of the former Suits actress. Christmas traditions are something that's very magical, especially when it comes to the royal family. The whole ordeal comes with a lot of events and rules, and one of those rules states that non-royal family members aren't really invited to the Queen's Christmas events. But the Queen broke that rule for the 2017 Christmas festivities. But in 2017, the Queen made waves in the media as she reportedly let Prince Harry bring Meghan Markle along with him. According to the royal author Andrew Morton, the Queen was very impressed by Meghan's performance in Suits, as Prince Harry actually showed her the clips of the show. So the Queen agreed, and Meghan was reportedly allowed to join in on a tradition that's normally strictly involving family members. Can I please have your autograph? Nope. The royals aren't allowed to sign autographs. Because being a member of the royal family comes with such an elite status, having extra security measures is extremely important, and one of those security measures are signatures. However, it is rumored that Queen Elizabeth II broke that rule herself after she signed a soccer ball when visiting Malaysia. But don't worry, even if she did reveal her signature, it was most likely the one she doesn't use for official documents. No touching. If The Untouchables had a remake, they'd have to include the Queen in the mix because, well, you really can't touch her. At least if you're an official that meets her or anyone that's not really a member of her close family. This is an extremely touchy subject in the media, pun intended, because truth be told, this rule tends to be broken more than any others. For example, in 2017, the Queen visited Canada House in London to celebrate Canada's 150th birthday. Media was sent in a complete frenzy because Governor General David touched the Queen's arm to protect her from a slippery carpet. By the looks of it, the Queen appreciated that gesture because she didn't even flinch. Michelle Obama said she broke the royal protocol without even realizing. In 2009, she hugged Queen Liz and actually got a hug back. Refusing a hug would probably stir even more media drama. Paying respects. In 2019, the Queen received heartbreaking news that her head housekeeper passed away. Annette Wilkin was serving the Queen for 40 years and was believed to be one of her longest-serving aides. Her passing came as a huge shock to the family, but many were left wondering whether or not the Queen would join the rest to pay her respects on the day people would say goodbye to Annette. This would involve breaking the royal protocol, as the appearance of the royals at such events should never be the focus of attention. But the Queen was very close with her head housekeeper, and over the years she reportedly even gave her her very own royal corgi. Her passing had a huge effect on her. As of June 1st, 2019, it is strongly believed that the Queen is breaking her own royal protocols. She will attend the event with everyone else to pay respects to her dear friend. No political talk. It's rare to see a British royal make any kind of statements about the current political affairs in the country or the world. This rule has been active for hundreds of years, and up until recently, every single member of the royal family allowed it. That's not to say they have no political views whatsoever, they just aren't allowed to share them. Why? because Buckingham Palace encourages the royals to support both sides of the political divide. But the ongoing frustration of the UK leaving the European Union, even the Queen couldn't hold back. In October 2018, she made her first non-rumored statement regarding Brexit. According to the reports, she told the King and Queen of the Netherlands that she's looking forward to a new partnership with Europe. She added that shared values between Britain and Europe are the country's greatest asset. It's not the first time the Queen reportedly made waves regarding Brexit. While this was her first non-rumored statement, the 2016 Brexit vote sent media in a frenzy. A rumor spread of the Queen actually backing Brexit with shocking headlines being published across the country. And seeing how the public reacted to those headlines, it makes complete sense that the royals stay away from politics as much as possible. And that's it for our video. Don't forget to subscribe and give this video a big thumbs up if you love the royal family. See you next time.